Hello everyone, welcome to this new session in Genetics and Molecular Biology. I am Dr. Yogesh Pawde. Under this BI 7.2 competency, which deals with DNA replication, DNA repair, transcription and translation mechanisms. So we are discussing DNA repair systems, and under this DNA repair system, today we will see nucleotide excision repair and base excision repair. These are the two DNA repair mechanisms. And the specific learning objectives of this session are, at the end of the session, students shall be able to describe nucleotide excision repair and describe base excision repair. Coming to nucleotide excision repair, before understanding the DNA repair mechanism, we must understand there are two strands in a newly formed DNA molecule. One is coming from the parent DNA and the other one is the newly synthesized DNA. And there are defects in newly synthesized DNA only after the DNA replication. So, how the DNA repair mechanism identifies the newly formed strand? So, the ability of DNA repair systems to identify a newly synthesized DNA strand or a nascent strand so that it can identify the errors more effectively and more easily. Okay. So, these DNA repair mechanisms, specifically nucleotide excision repair, takes place along with the replication process. So it is ongoing process along with the replication. So it is a part of proofreading activity of the DNA polymerases. The original template DNA, which contains methylated residues, that means methylated nucleotides are there, which are specifically N6 methyl adenine and 5 methyl cytosine. Because the newly synthesized DNA strand do not have methylated bases, so the enzyme can identify the strand with methylated bases, that is original one, and the strand without methylated bases, that is the new strand. Okay. The DNA repair system will identify the defect in the newly synthesized DNA. The helicase enzyme will unwind the DNA. The mismatch base is identified. It is here and removed by the endonuclease. This endonuclease enzyme will remove around 24 to 32 nucleotides around the wrong base. Okay, this is the wrong base. It not only removes the wrong base, but around 24 to 32 nucleotides around the wrong base, means around 12 to 15 nucleotides upstream, 12 to 15 nucleotides downstream. So a fragment of total around 30 nucleotides will be removed with its 5 prime to 3 prime exonuclease activity. As the endonuclease cleaves at two points, because it is not cleaving here only, it is cleaving at this point as well as this point, the enzyme is sometimes called as exonuclease. This complete portion of around 32 nucleotides around the wrong base is degraded. Here a small segment of DNA with correct base sequence is then synthesized by DNA polymerase beta. We have seen in the previous sessions that the DNA polymerase beta has proofreading activity. It is mainly involved in DNA repair along with DNA epsilon. Okay. So the DNA polymerase beta here synthesizes a small segment of DNA with correct base sequence. So the last role of DNA ligase is also there. Then the gap or the nick is sealed by DNA ligase with energy input of ATP. Okay. So this covers the nucleotide excision repair. Let us summarize briefly what is happening here. The DNA repair mechanism identifies a wrong base, but not only the wrong base is removed, but 24 to 32 nucleotides around the wrong base are removed with the help of 5 prime to 3 prime exonuclease activity. This endonuclease is also called as exonuclease. This DNA fragment will be degraded and this gap will be filled by DNA polymerase beta. And the nick is going to be sealed with DNA polymerase and the whole newly synthesized DNA strand will be repaired. So this is what the nucleotide excision repair was. Now coming to base excision repair, the nitrogenous base will be repaired. Why this base excision repair is required? The deprotonation of DNA is a spontaneous process. And the deprioritization of DNA is continuously happening, maybe around at the rate of 10,000 events of deprioritization per cell per day. So cytosine to uracil, adenine to hypoxanthine and guanine to xanthine is the usual spontaneous process which is happening. So that is deprioritization of DNA. If cytosine is deaminated to uracil, the adenine will be inserted to pair with U, because otherwise uracil is not present in DNA. But if the cytosine is deaminated to uracil, as a rule of complementarity, A will be inserted to pair with the newly formed uracil, thus leading to a mutation. And this pathway repairs modified bases or abasic sites produced by depurination or depyrimidination. Whatever the modified bases, like cytosine to uracil, or maybe adenine to hypoxanthine, or guanine to xanthine, because of depurination are formed, those modified bases or abasic sites which are produced by depurination or depyrimidination will be repaired by base excision repair. This is the exclusive repair process or the mechanism available for modified bases or abasic sites. The modified bases are first removed by DNA glycosylase. So DNA glycosylase is the enzyme which has a crucial role in base excision repair, which after removal of the modified bases produces, that is called as abasic site. And the cell has a range of different DNA glycosylases that are specific for common modified bases. So maybe for each modified base, the cell has different DNA glycosylase. These are two DNA glycosylases which are usually seen, that is 8-oxoguanine DNA glycosylase and uracil DNA glycosylase. Uracil DNA glycosylase will always be there because cytosine to uracil is happening at a very frequent rate. Okay, so maybe 10,000 events per cell per day. Now the abasic sites are formed, right? So how the abasic sites will be repaired? They are usually repaired by excising the remaining sugar phosphate residue. See, in a nucleotide, when base is removed, what remains is the sugar phosphate, and the sugar phosphate residue will be removed, and removed with the help of phosphodiesterase enzyme and specialized endonuclease which is present to remove a sugar phosphate residue without any nitrogenous base attached to it. Okay, then inserting the correct nucleotide to match the undamaged complemented DNA strand by DNA ligase. So two processes: excising the sugar phosphate residue and inserting the correct nucleotide to match the undamaged complemented DNA strand by DNA ligase. Then coming to the activities of the enzymes, look at this. This is the nucleotide and this is the uracil which is formed here. This uracil will be removed by glycosylase enzyme. So this uracil glycosylase will hydrolyze the glycosidic bond here. This uracil glycosylase will hydrolyze this glycosidic bond to release uracil from the DNA backbone. From this nucleotide, by cleaving glycosidic bond, this uracil will be removed and this will lead to a apurinic site, AP site, that is apurinic, or in this case apyrimidinic site, because cytosine is converted into uracil and that was pyrimidine. So this is apyrimidinic site. In this case, this AP endonuclease or apurinic endonuclease which cleave the DNA backbone at 5' end. This is the 5' end, this is the 3' end. This AP endonuclease will cleave the DNA backbone at 5' end of the AP site. So this is the AP site, 5' end will be this. So AP endonuclease will cleave DNA strand at 5' end of the AP site. So leaving 3' OH group of this base so that the new nucleotide can be added to this end of the nucleotide in this segment. Then there is a role of exonuclease which is going to cut at 3' end. to release this AP site from this strand, it has to be cut at 5 prime end and 3 prime end of the AP uronic site. So the AP endonuclease has cleaved it at the 5 prime end of the AP site. Now we need to cleave it at 3 prime end of the AP site, so that this phosphate group will be open. So this exonuclease will cut at 3 prime end of the AP site, leaving the 5 prime phosphate of this nucleoside open. And a proper base is then added by DNA polymerase alpha, and this nick here will be sealed by DNA ligase. Okay, so this was base excision repair. Let us summarize what was it. Depurination is a common spontaneous process, right? So it will form modified bases on abasic sites by depurination or depyrimidination, and the DNA glycosylase is the enzyme which removes the modified bases producing abasic sites. So these are the two DNA glycosylases, 8-oxoguanine DNA glycosylase and uracil DNA glycosylase, and the abasic sites are first removed by removing the remaining sugar phosphate residue with the help of phosphodiesterase and specific endonuclease, and later on the nick will be sealed by the DNA ligase. Here the uracil glycosylase will remove this uracil by cleaving the glycosidic bond and will form a AP site. It is a pyrimidinic site, and now this AP site needs to be removed. So there are two enzymes which will act on it. One is AP endonuclease, which will act on this 5 prime end of the AP site, and the exonuclease will act on the 3 prime end of the AP site, leaving this phosphate group open to undergo ligation by the DNA ligase activity. Okay, so this was regarding base excision repair, and we have covered today the nucleotide excision repair as well as base excision repair. This is the literature which you can refer for the deeper studies on these two topics. Thanks for watching. Hope you have subscribed to the channel. If not, kindly subscribe and press the bell button so that you'll get the notifications of the upcoming channels in real time. Thank you so much. Keep watching, keep learning, and keep motivating us.